I am cleaning my kitchen and I went on this whole spiral of remembering my celebrity crushes. I mean, it is Mercury retrograde in Capricorn and it's also Mars retrograde. I decided to watch my playlist entitled Celebrity Crushes, and I'm just watching the first video. The first video is where I basically manifested all for the rest of the videos in the playlist is all because of this video. And I should just tell you that for years before I filmed this, my celebrity boyfriend's video, I had gone on and on delusional about how I'm gonna meet these celebrity boyfriends, specific details about our dates. And back then, I was just so caught up. I have a Pisces moon and I have a four planet Cancer stellium. I was just so caught up in the fantasy. This is how I am. This is how I always been. I get a crush on a guy. I never talk to them. In fact, I'm actually afraid of them. In fact, I actually want to hide. I don't want them to know that I exist. But meanwhile, in my journals, in my mind, I fantasize. So when it came to celebrities in high school, I just put it all out there. I made t-shirts, I wrote their names everywhere. So I had been going through this with these celebrity boyfriends, I had been for about 10 years at least. And so when I made this video, the manifestation was well underway. So we're gonna be reacting to that right now. And I'm also washing the dishes, so two birds with one stone. It's Mercury retrograde.
Oh, it's me, Chadu, and what you hear. Oh, I guess my dog stopped barking. But if you hear a cute little bark of a beagle, that's my cute little baby. Yeah, there's some new people in my house right now, so she's kind of on the defense, but she's all bark, no bite. She's
right off the bat, I look really different. I look really different. Macrobiotics. Anyway, and it's just really funny because I can tell in my face now that I know non-invasive diagnosis what was happening so clearly. And not just my face, but the way that I talked and my expression, even the sound of my voice. It's so crazy.
She wouldn't hurt a fly. She's so sweet. Anyway, Lacey just wants to be your friend. Like my sweatshirt that says, looking for a best friend or in search of a best friend or something. Or BFF, that's what it says.
Cringe.
Yeah.
Cringe.
This
is going to be my celebrity boyfriend's vlog. Yeah, I was talking about this with someone.
The person I'm talking about right there, I was in love with this guy. P.S. He was another musician. Surprise. I was in love with that guy since I was like 15. For about 10 years, I was in love with that guy. Michelle, you're in love with this guy? You're in love with that guy? Yeah, I have Gemini Venus. And they're all musicians.
Today, and they were like, is this a video you have up on your channel? It's like, you know what? No, but it would make a great topic of discussion. Because I always find it really interesting. I think you can tell a lot.
God, I'm just so cringy. P.S. I don't even want to listen to it. It's so cringy. I don't even want to see myself because I'm like, it's just so cringy. And this was also in a time where I wasn't sleeping. Can you tell? That was in a time where I wasn't sleeping because demons were visiting me, yada, yada, yada. I also wasn't grooming myself. Okay? Okay.
From a person by their celebrity boyfriends. So I have about five celebrity boyfriends. One of them definitely stands out among the rest.
The rest
At
of
the
them
time, at the time.
Pretty much
equally on the same level in my heart, but I have one that stands alone. And let's just start with him. Nick Zinner from the Yeah.
P.S. We still talk. P.S. We still talk. Anyway.
He's the guitarist. I love him. What else can I say? He's not. I think he's. The reasons why I like him is I think he's so cute.
I think he's very cute.
He's a really talented musician. And I follow him on Twitter, and he's pretty funny.
He is. Sagittarius.
He actually kind of looks, he's not conventionally cute.
Like, same.
Looks gross. Well, because he kind of looks like a vampire. Like, I'm not into that whole vampire craze, but.
Yeah, what year was this? Talking about vampires? Let's see, what year was that? 2013. That True Blood, Twilight, yeah, I never got into it, but yeah, I like Nick Center.
Really thin, really pale, black crazy hair, kind of like Edward Scissorhands, but a bit more groomed. If you're like, WTF, like, why do you like this guy? Well, let me direct you to the song Turn Into off their album, Show Your Bones.
Another level of cringe. My boyfriend that I've been with for the past almost 7 years, he's a jazz musician. If you guys know anything about jazz, it's a very complicated style of music. And if we're gonna like put a hierarchy about levels of respect for talent, for hard work, jazz is at the top. It's on par with classical music, maybe even higher. And when I met Tom, I was not into jazz. Still, I'm like, about jazz. But at least now I know everything it takes to be a jazz musician and how jazz music is so much more complicated, how you have to have a better understanding of music. And feeling, it was a point, oh my God, so embarrassing. When I first met Tom, we were showing each other different pieces of music that we liked. And I had really no concept of jazz, really. And I showed him that song, Turn Into, and I said, yeah, Tom. I was like, yeah, you think that guitar solo was great? Check this out. And I showed him that part that I was talking about. And it's so, now that I know, it's so like, I bet you in Tom's mind, he was like, stupid girl. Like, because it was so, what I thought was cool, what was complicated, what was unique up until that point, like on comparison to jazz, it's like so like kindergarten level. So embarrassing that I'm like hyping it up to be so much when it's like, girl, you don't even know. So embarrassing. Oh my God.
I think it's hard for me to say one of their best albums, but if I had to choose, I think that would be my favorite.
Maybe
still.
So it's a song off there, and towards the end of the song, there's like, just totally like, it just got me, and I was like, you know what, he's the one for me. I'm
going to marry him.
So much that, you know, and like, I basically memorized his Wikipedia page. What?
Stalker.
Right? So one time I'm in Macy's with my friend. We're like just walking through it to like get to the mall. And I walk by the Betsy Johnson display and, of course, have to stop because it's Betsy Johnson. Yeah.
Oh my God, I'm so annoying. How did I have any friends ever my whole life? I get it why I was a loner. I get it. Whatchamacallit? What did they say? History is 2020 or something like that?
Yeah.
Shut up.
And even though I'm not really into designers, okay, anyway, I'm getting off topic. So I saw these little babies. They are little rhinestones.
I know what you're gonna ask me. Do I still have those earrings? No. I sold them on Poshmark.
Stone camera earrings. They're not, they don't actually take photography or film or anything.
No one thought that.
Of course.
Who did I think of? My future husband, Nick Zinner. So, I came up with this right on the spot. I came back, I was like, Shanice.
She's like, what? And then I go.
She was like that.
Okay. I'm gonna go to one of the I'm gonna go to both concerts, because usually when a big artist comes to LA, they play two shows. I'm gonna go to both shows. This could happen at the first or the second, but probably the second, because I would love to see the Yeah Yeah Yeahs twice. But
okay, that's a true groupie right there. I'm gonna go to both shows, okay? And no, he could propose the first night or the second night, but no, he's gonna propose. He's gonna propose the second night. That way, I get to see the Yeah Yeah Yeahs twice. That's a true groupie.
It could happen at either one, but this is what's gonna happen. I'm gonna wear these camera earrings, and no matter where I am in the audience, if I have front row seats or the all the way in the back, I'm gonna be wearing those earrings, and Nick Zinner is gonna be like, he's gonna stop the show. He's gonna be like, Michelle Williams. I'm gonna be like, yes. He's gonna like, please come to the stage, and I will come, and I will like float down, float to the stage.
Not to spoiler alert, but the rest of the videos in that playlist, but I kind of already told you, it is crazy how I'm kind of friends with Nick Zinner. So that whole thing that I just described, like no matter where I am, Nick Zinner is gonna connect with me, and I'm gonna float. It's like, how many, I mean, I don't know, but how many people out there are a fan of his and have tried to connect with him, and how many actually have done that and maintained it throughout the years? And I did feel, and I still feel like so, like a floating, like Pisces moon, like floating, like that we have that connection. It's just so crazy. In a way, it happened.
Right. And then he's gonna come up with a song for me on his guitar, and it's gonna be the most beautiful song ever, and people are gonna be crying, be brought to tears. And then he's gonna get down on one knee and ask me to marry him, and I'm gonna be like, duh, of course. And then so we're gonna get married, and I'm gonna have a Vera Wang dress.
First of all, irresponsible. See, back then, I was so freaking delusional. I really didn't know. Because two, I didn't have any experience with, I'm gonna say, a real relationship or a healthy one. But now, even now, like, if I watch a movie or a show and people get married, like, so fast, I'm like, what? You don't even know him. Why are you getting married? And especially now that I have so much more insight about rock stars and celebrities and musicians and Sagittarius. I'm like, how about let's wait before you say yes to marry that guy? I mean, I don't care how big of a fan you are. Like, what are you doing, girl?
Duh. I mean, what else am I gonna wear? With a picture of my dog, Lacey, on it.
Walk down the aisle, tag song, if you don't know the
awesome song, it's...
Oh my god, don't sing. Oh my god, don't sing. Even though I sing literally every day, don't sing, Michelle's so cringe.
Do 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 do. Yeah. Okay, that's the song I'm gonna walk down the aisle to. My dog Lacey is gonna be.
Look at these details.
Awesome.
Manifestation.
And when, like when people leave the church.
What
they
are you gonna
like,
say? I don't
set
know.
Doves.
And the doves fly. Well, people are gonna set beagle puppies free, and the beagles are gonna chase, they're gonna run.
Yeah, if you didn't know, my previous social media handle used to be The Beagle Queen, and then about 5 years ago I changed it to The Freedom Fairy. Yeah, so that's what this whole obsession
walking.
Is.
Walking.
My veil in the wind, and all these little puppies going with their little ears and their little tail doing this. Yeah, it's gonna be so cute. And then all the guests could like choose their beagle. And if people don't want the beagle, like why wouldn't they want one? So dumb. But if they don't want them, then Nick Zinner and I are gonna adopt them. Because me and Nick Zinner, we're gonna have like a beagle farm. But like,
not like a puppy mill, but like a farm where we just like take care of beagles and make them have more babies.
And make them?
The amount of beagle puppies we have, so we don't get like more than we can handle.
Wait,
we're gonna give them away as like birthday presents, Christmas
oh
presents.
Oh my god,
No!
A graduation gift. And, you know, any time that...
No.
A promotion.
That's so wrong.
You get a beagle puppy. You know?
So, that's how we're going to do it. But... Okay, so that is the next dinner. I think that's it. Okay, so then the next celebrity boyfriends, they're all, like, they're cute, they're talented. They're on the same level. Like, if Nick Zinner and I don't work out, which, of course, they're going to, but, I mean, in an insane world where this scenario doesn't happen.
Sound
delusional?
Okay,
he's the lead singer of the band Weezer, but Rivers Cuomo in the 90s when he was young, even with his little bull haircut like he had in the Say It Ain't So music video, I think he was cute. He's like a nerdy cute, okay? He went to Harvard, yeah. I like that.
Big whoop!
Yeah, because now he's like 40-something.
And I said, if he's
past 40, then he's not going to be my celebrity boyfriend anymore.
Oh my god, so ageist. Oh my god. Meanwhile, how old is my boyfriend now? So ageist.
So, he missed his chance.
Next one.
And Paul Banks from Interpol. He's like really attractive. He's like blonde hair, blue eyes.
Like such a pretty white boy. But not like
conventional pretty white boy, because he's got like a lot of moles and a lot of people are like,
oh, girl.
I like how I'm talking about how these are my crushes. Meanwhile, I'm like lightly shading all of them. What? If they heard the way that I was talking about them, they'd be like, okay, so why do you like me? Because it sounds like you're being mean.
I still think he's cute. And his haircut, his like newer haircut that he got, I don't know if he still has it, but like,
oh my god.
It was like, he didn't spike it. Yeah, it didn't look good on him.
But
oh my god.
And I know people are like, oh, he's so monotone.
Virgo rising.
I'm like, oh my god.
It's so like interesting. I don't know. It's like different. And I like it. But yeah, like the old Interpol music videos and like performances on like Letterman and stuff, like it was so young, it's so attractive.
And plus he was
ages.
Like
what?
Well, he can skate.
Like skateboards. Like that is cute to me.
My god. P.S. I was talking about his moles. Again, my boyfriend today, he has like 1,000 moles.
Like I was always attracted to that, like even in middle school.
Okay. Get over it.
From The Killers.
He could still get it.
Like he's like,
oh, he could still get it.
Like if I imagine like a real life prince, he would look like.
And his voice is just like
cute.
Really
sad, but it's like, just like beautiful. Yeah.
Brandon Flowers is a Cancer. He also has Cancer Mercury, like me, but except his is retrograde. Everyone that thinks having your natal Mercury retrograde and you think that's a bad thing, I mean, look how it worked out for Brandon Flowers. Mm-hmm.
The last one, Chris Martin from Coldplay. I think he's kind of getting up near
for you.
Oh my god! Shut up! Oh my god. So crazy because like, I was so obsessed with age. Like, oh my god, he's gonna be 40. Ew. Meanwhile, like, I feel like now it's so crazy. Just my whole life experience, I feel like the guy has to be older than me now. It has to be. So if he was 40, like, again, in comparison to my boyfriend now, if I get a boyfriend after or a husband or whatever, it's like, it's actually going to be like, oh, I'm with a young man.
He's British. Did I say he's from Coldplay? Yeah. I think he's the most, like, one that people can be like, oh, okay, he's cute. Yeah, because the other ones are like, and Brandon Flowers.
Yeah, he's just like,
they're all white.
Like, Coldplay in concert, and he was just like really, like, dancing, and I was like, oh, he's not afraid to show his passion.
Oh my god, because I used to be like, that's so crazy. When I was younger, I was so like trapped, like
my throat chakra was all like closed off, and it had a lot to do with a lot of things. I just felt like people who express themselves freely, because I couldn't do that, I felt like scared for them, or I felt like people were judging them. And I also judged them, because that's also why I didn't want to express myself, because I thought I was going to be judged. So it's just funny at this point, I'm like acknowledging that expressing yourself is actually very cool. And that's actually why I liked Chris Martin.
Well, I mean, of course, none of them are afraid, otherwise they wouldn't be famous now. Those are my celebrity boyfriends. Okay, let's see. Nixoner, Rivers, Paul Banks, Brandon Flowers, Chris Martin. Yeah. Five celebrity boyfriends, one of them my future husband, and if not,
then any of the other ones are fine, except for Rivers, because he's old.
Oh, I mean, my God! He's
probably old, too.
Shut up! Yeah,
once they get to
40, I'm like, sorry, unless I magically get older faster. If I was 30 and they were 40, okay, maybe.
I'm 30.
But
I'm 32.
And Nick Zinner, I think he's 38 or 39 right
Wait,
now.
Am I 33?
So, but they're coming out with a new 32. Album.
Mosquito. Mosquito. Mosquito.
Oh my God, Michelle.
April 16th. Soup's exy about that.
Oh my God.
So yeah, so guys.
I mean, I don't have a ring on my finger yet, but.
Might as well imagine there is, because I'm going to see them.
We're going to get married and all that stuff is going to come true. Okay, peace bunnies.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Okay, the way that I promote their new, the Yeah Yeah Yeah's new album at the time, and the way that I still do, is like, that is such groupie behavior. Okay, there's no shame in it, but it's just so funny. I don't get any kickback from it, but yet I promote them like I'm gonna make a difference in their sales. Who knows? You never know. But then also, at the end when I say peace bunnies, I used to say that. That used to be my sign off. I don't know why. I used to call my viewers bunnies. I don't know why. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed this reaction video. I'm really embarrassed by it. I knew that I was ageist, but I didn't know I was that, like, oh my God, Michelle. Should I private that video? P.S. Chris Martin is, I think he is single, or at least he's not married, I think. So, you never know. And then plus he's British, so that's kind of connecting back to my roots. So you never know. And he used to be vegan / macrobiotic, so that's something. Also, Nick Zinner was vegan. And we talked about that. We talked about that in the DMs. And we also talk about macrobiotics. Yeah. I'm so surprised he hasn't blocked me. He probably just thinks it's hilarious. Some random fan is obsessed with him. But anyway, which that is dangerous territory. You're playing with fire when you're a celebrity and you interact with crazy fans, crazy obsessed fans. And I know, but I think when you're a guy and your crazy fan is a girl, I mean, they kind of let it slide. You feel me? But anyways, yeah, thanks for watching. Peace.